Okay. We are going to fix position, set a course, determine a DR, and then create or find our set and drift. So the first thing we need to do is find our fixed position. So our position given to us was 41.10.0. So on the left-hand side of the chart, we find 41 and move up until we find the 10. 41.10.0, so we know that we're somewhere on this line. The other position given to us, for the sake of ease, is 73.000. So 41.10 and 73 meet right here. So where that position meets is our starting position. Our given time is 0700. So we label the position. Our given course is 90 degrees true. So we go to the compass rose. We find 90 degrees true on the outside part of the rose. And we will create a straight line, parallel up, 90 degrees true, and we'll draw a line. And we'll label that 090 degrees. And the speed given for the problem is 5 knots. We'll also label that. Speed is 5 knots. The next time given to us is 7:45. So we need to determine where we would have a dead reckoning, where we think we should be at 7:45. So we need to do a distance, speed, and time problem to determine our DR. So our DR, distance is unknown. Our speed given to us is 5 knots. Our time is 7:45 for our new position and 7 o'clock for our departure. We do that math. We find out that we have 45 minutes has been underway. We need to convert that 45 minutes to a decimal by dividing by 60. So we take 45 divided by 60, 60 minutes to an hour, equals 0.75. 0.75 becomes our decimal time. We're going to take that now. Speed times time equals distance. 0.75 minutes, hour, times our speed of 5 knots equals 3.75. That's our distance traveled over 45 minutes. We take that 3.75, we go to our dividers. On the side of the chart, we find 3.75 miles. 1, 2, 3. Point 0.5, point 0.6, point 0.75. 3.75. We put one end of the divider at our starting position at 7 o'clock. We take the other end of the divider, put it on our course line, make a mark. That becomes our DR position at 0745. That's a DR. Take that further. At some point in time, at 7:45, we refix our position using GPS or landmarks, and we discover that our new position was at 41.09.0. So we find 41.09, and our other position given to us on our GPS, so our latitude and longitude, was 72.54.5. So we're going to take that off the top. 54.5. We're going to transpose that down. And we're going to know that our new position is where those two meet. That's a new fix at 0745. So Now what's happened? We've traveled along this course, assumedly, and we anticipated, we reckoned that we would be at this position at 7:45. In reality, we found ourselves to be at this position at 7:45 through looking at our GPS, finding our latitude long, or crossed bearings, or some other means to mark position. So what's happened is the current has forced us off course in that direction. So we take and we make a line from our DR to our new position. That's our set line, the direction the current has set us. We bring that down to the center of the compass rose. We were set in this direction, so we were set at this number of degrees. In this case, 161 degrees. So our set is 161 degrees. Now we need to determine the speed of the current. That's drift. Speed of the current is the distance from our DR to our new position. So we'll get a measurement on that, again on the side of the chart. And that distance is 1.2 miles. So distance, speed, and time once again. Distance was 1.2 miles. Our time underway for this problem has been the same. It's 0.75, 45 minutes, so 0.75. So we take our calculator. We take our distance of 1.2 miles, divide it by our speed, 0.75, and we get a speed of 1.6 knots. That speed is our drift. That's how fast the current is going. Drift. Now we can determine something else. We can determine what course we actually made. From 7 o'clock to our new fix at 7:45, our course, our vessel traveled in this direction. We connect those, roll it to the center of the compass rose, and since we're traveling more easterly, we're just going to come from the center of the compass rose out to the edge of the compass rose, and we find that we traveled, that course is approximately 107 degrees. And that's called our course made good, the course we actually made over the water. The next thing we can determine is our speed made good. How fast did we actually travel? Again, we're going to have to find the distance we went, the distance we traveled over 45 minutes. Determine that by the side of the chart. And we find out that that distance is equal to 4.4 nautical miles. And we're doing another distance, speed, and time problem. Our speed is unknown. That's what we're solving for. Our time, the time has remained the same. It's still 0.75 from 7 o'clock until 7:45. So we'll take our calculator and we'll say 4.4 is our distance divided by our time of 0.75. And we get an answer of 5.8666666666. So we'll just round that up to 5.9. And we'll say that our speed made good was 5.9 knots. So our speed for this problem, we advanced somewhat. We thought we were doing 5, but because the current actually assisted us, we made 5.9 knots, and we traveled a distance of 4.4 nautical miles. That's DR, set, drift, course made good, speed made good.